Assalamu alaikum, welcome back to another ATP video. Today we'll be talking about Proteus Mirabilis. It'll be a short, concise video, and we hope you get the benefit out of it. There are actually many Proteus species, such as Proteus vulgaris and Proteus penuri, but today we'll be focusing only on Proteus Mirabilis. To start with, Proteus belongs to a big family of bacteria known as Enterobacteriaceae, which are gram-negative rods that live in the intestines. Now let's talk about the features of Proteus mirabilis. This organism is a facultative anaerobic bacillus, which means it can grow in both the presence or the absence of oxygen. It's most commonly found in the human intestinal tract as part of normal flora, and they specifically colonize the colon and the urethra, especially in females. It's uniquely characterized by its vigorous motility and its ability to produce urease enzyme, and we'll be talking about the importance of these later in the video. Proteus possesses certain virulence factors that enables it to cause disease. First of all, Proteus mirabilis exhibits flagella that allows the organism to be freely motile. Also, it possesses fimbria that facilitates its attachment to the epithelium of the host tissue. And in our case, it's the uroepithelial cells of the urinary tract. Another striking feature about Proteus is that it produces the enzyme urease, which hydrolyzes the urea in the urine into ammonia and carbon dioxide. This in turn raises the pH and produces an alkaline urine. Now, in regards to its transmission, we have mentioned before that Proteus species are part of the human intestinal flora, so they can cause infection upon leaving that location. They may also be transmitted through contaminated catheters, particularly urinary catheters, or by accidental parenteral inoculation. However, the specific mode of transmission has not been identified yet. Proteus primarily causes urinary tract infections that are both community and hospital acquired. And as we have explained before, Proteus exhibits some virulence factors such as the flagella, the fimbria, and the ability to produce urease enzyme, which turns the urine environment into an alkaline one, and thus facilitating the survival of the organism. Not only does this alkaline urine facilitate the survival of Proteus, it also promotes the formation of kidney stones, called struvite, which are composed of magnesium, ammonium, and phosphate. These struvite stones often manifest as staghorn calculi in the renal pelvis. Calculi is another name for kidney stones. Proteus classically causes signs and symptoms of urinary tract infection, such as dysuria, urinary frequency, and flank pain. And as you can see, these signs and symptoms cannot distinguish Proteus infection from other members of Enterobacteriaceae, like E. coli for instance. There are many biochemical tests and methods that can identify Proteus species, but we'll be mentioning only some of them. Proteus can be identified on different culture plates, for example, blood agar. As the organism produces expanding waves on the surface of the agar, this effect is known as swarming effect, which is attributed to the vigorous motility of the organism, and it owes that to the flagella that we spoke about before. In addition to that, Proteus can grow on McConkie's agar, and since it's a non-lactose fermenting organism, it produces colorless colonies. Furthermore, it can grow on TSI agar as well, as it produces a black color due to its ability to produce hydrogen sulfide. Another thing about Proteus species is that the urine sample that contains the organism often produces a very distinct fishy odor. Now for the treatment. Most Proteus strains are sensitive to extended spectrum ampicillin, trimethoprim sulfamethoxazole, and cephalosporins. After we've discussed everything about Proteus mirabilis, now the question arises, how can we prevent the infection? Unfortunately, there are no specific preventive measures and no vaccines are available at the present time. However, many hospital-acquired UTIs can be prevented by prompt removal of urinary catheters. Alright, to wrap it up. Today we have talked about Proteus mirabilis. We have said that it's a gram-negative rod that's part of the normal human GI flora. It primarily causes UTIs, and it's characterized by its ability to produce a distinct fishy odor in the urine, and its ability to produce an alkaline urine that promotes the formation of struvite stones that can manifest as staghorn calculi. It can be identified on blood agar by its unique swarming motility, And finally, it can be treated with ampicillin, trimethoprim sulfamethoxazole, and cephalosporins. And that's it for Proteus Mirabilis. We hope you found it beneficial. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to receive our latest updates. And as always, thanks for watching.